Today, ang topic natin is nourished by sharing the gospel. No, nourished by sharing the gospel. Something that I believe that most of you, if not all of you, should really learn about. Kasi, you know, this is something na very relevant sa buhay natin, especially in our walk with the Lord. Some people do not really understand why is it na minsan parang tinatamad sila, why is it na parang wala silang gana sa spiritual life, you know, and they feel guilty about it. There are actually practical reasons why, and we'll talk about it. So, if you are ready, let's read our scripture for today, which is, you know, towards the end of a certain incident na nangyari. Where Jesus met with a Samaritan woman, and he shared the gospel with her, and she was, of course, enlightened, no? But the disciples were not there when it happened, so they came eventually, and they were inviting Jesus to eat. So let's pick it up at verse 31, John 4, verse 31 hanggang verse 34. Tapos we'll pray, okay? So sabi sa verse 31, meanwhile, his disciples urged him, Rabbi, eat something. But he said to them, I have food to eat that you know nothing about. Verse 33, then his disciples said to each other, could someone have brought him food? And then verse 34 says, my food, said Jesus, is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. So let us all pray and ask God to guide us and speak to our hearts sa pagkakataong ito so that we may understand His will and purpose para sa atin. Amen? So tayong lahat po ay manalangin. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity once again to come together online and to journey together in the Lord by meditating on your word, Panginoon. So Lord, I pray that you would allow each of us, Panginoon, to receive your word gladly and really be able to understand and grasp the truth and the principles that you want us to hear, Lord God, through this devotional. I pray for everyone, wherever they might be right now, that you would give them the grace to listen well and alisin mo yung mga distractions sa paligid nila, sa saan man, sa puso nila, whatever. Help them to just focus, O God, and gamitin mo rin ako, Panginoon. Give me the grace to be able to share your word with everyone who are listening right now. And I thank God for technology. Salamat po, Panginoon, na there are no boundaries now. We can reach people wherever they are, kahit sa parte ng mundo. And for that, I'm truly grateful, Panginoon. So, Lord, may your presence truly be with us as you promised, O God. As we meditate on your word, we acknowledge that you are here with us, Panginoon. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your Holy Spirit. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Now, you know, some people, some Christians actually, so let's be more specific, no? Minsan, ang feeling nila parang there's really nothing exciting about being a Christian at all, you know. It's, in fact, sometimes they even conclude na it's quite boring, no? And yung kanilang spiritual life is not really what you might call exciting. It's really just routine, you know, just going through the motions, and they wonder sometimes siguro, sometimes out loud, you know, they would say this. Other times naman, they just keep it to themselves. Now, is it all there is to it? You know, ito lang ba yun? You're going to Sunday service, ganyan, and just maintaining yung religious obligations natin. In other words, they don't really feel very much alive, you know, in their relationship with God. And why is that? Okay. Why is it na parang yung faith natin matamlay? Well, actually, most people don't know this, but it really has to do with our choices of where we actually place ourselves. We have been talking about places of grace, meaning to say na merong mga lugar that if you intentionally, you know, factor it in your life and make sure that you have the rule of life na well-balanced, na you make sure that you are in those places, you know, by faith, and that you are truly focused on what God can and will do in those places, you will actually experience, you know, a rejuvenated and enriched and, you know, exciting walk with the Lord, because it is in the presence of God that we experience joy and peace and power, you know, to be able actually to experience yung life as it was really meant to be and overcome yung mga challenges of this life. It's actually right there in the presence of God that we can receive grace after grace after grace sa buhay natin. And not factoring that in, not making sure na yung life natin is in a rhythm of grace, so that we actually do not compromise or we do not set it aside, but really make sure na regularly we put ourselves in those places of grace as part of our lifestyle, no? And as far as part of our faith, okay? So people who don't do that, eventually they suffer, of course, the consequences of that. Now, I've been talking about places of grace for quite a while now dito sa series natin ngayon. I think we started for several weeks now, di ba? And I've been talking about, so far, no, tatlong places of grace na ang nabibring up ko na sa inyong attention. The first one is yung tinatawag na, you know, silence and solitude. Or in other words, being with God alone and communing with Him, listening to His voice in our hearts and praying and, you know, reading scripture by ourselves, or sometimes even, you know, fasting and just resting in His presence. Yung magkaroon ka nung ganung regular habit, okay? As part of your lifestyle and your rule of life, making sure that you do not neglect that, na hindi ka super busy, that you don't have any time to be alone with God, to hear His voice, that would nurture your faith. That would keep your faith alive. Unfortunately, this busyness ng mundong ito, people actually neglect doing that. No, maraming Christians, they wonder, ba't kaya ang tamlay ng aking spiritual life? And if you ask them, so tell me about your walk with the Lord. And if they are honest, they would say, well, you know, hindi na nga ako masyado makapag-pray siguro, or busy nga ako masyado, nami kong ginagawa, you know. Well, you know, that's really the reason for it, okay? Kaya ka nagiging matamlay spiritually is because you are neglecting yung connection mo with the vine, the source of life, who is Jesus Himself. So you are not putting yourself in a place of grace, no? And I'm not saying na, you know, tatalikod ka na sa mundong ito at you know, pupunta ka na lang sa bundok, you know, and magko-quiet time ka na lang doon. That's not what I mean. But regularly, as part of our schedule, we make sure, no, that we do not become so hurried, so busy, that we fail to actually hear the voice of God. Now, God speaks in a still small voice in our hearts, pero we cannot hear it if we are so busy and tuliru tayo sa maraming bagay. So we really have to make a choice, no? We make sure that we, you know, live our lives, we arrange our life in such a way na meron tayong regular and ample time to be alone with the Lord. At ganun din yung ano, yung sacred assemblies and coming together as the people of God, being connected in community. Now again, ito, this is so basic, no? Pero some people don't really connect this with their experience kasi iniisip nila, well, nood lang ako ng service siguro online, or maybe kung wala pa yon, saka na lang kasi marami akong gustong puntahan. And then after several days or weeks of not being connected to God's people, they begin to experience yung parang walang buhay, no, sa kanilang faith, and they wonder bakit gano'n, no? Because you are disconnected. It's because you do not make priority to be connected with the people of God. And I'm not just talking about attending a worship service. Kasi you can be in a worship service and still feel the same way, na parang walang buhay yung spiritual walk mo with the Lord. Because it's really about the people of God, really connecting in relationships, in life-giving relationships with people, being in a place where people know you and you know them, and, you know, experiencing God together, okay, and praying together, learning the Word of God together. So this is a priority. This is a place of grace. Whenever we come together, sabi nga ni Jesus, when two or more come together or gather, you know, in my name, there I am in the midst of them. So we experience the presence of God together. And so, napaka-simpleng bagay, pero madalas na ni-neglect ng maraming Kristiyano ito. They set aside yung kahalagahan of being together as God's people, worshiping and praying and listening to God's word in fellowship with each other, in communion with each other by, you know, by God's grace. Kinakaligtaan natin to, and we sometimes we wonder, you know, ba't kaya parang matamlay ako, wala akong gana spiritually, ba't parang nanlalamig ako, ba't parang lukewarm ako? Well, just look at your, ano, the way you're living your life, okay? Kasi where you spend most of your time is what actually influences you and forms your heart. So kung puro worldly things ang ginagawa natin, I mean, wag tayong ma-surprise that we become worldly people. Okay? And I'm not saying na hindi na tayo makapag-enjoy because we can actually enjoy more of life if we are properly centered, no? If we are centered in God. Now, the third place na napag-usapan na natin, and I'm just reviewing lang naman before we dive into this new place that we want to talk about, is of course yung place for soul conversations or soul talks, yung mga one-on-one talks about our soul, about our spiritual walk. That's a place of grace. At pag wala tayong ganyan, wala tayong mga experiences of sitting down with a friend, a spiritual friend or director, and really sharing what is going on sa buhay natin so that we can co-discern together kung ano ba yung what is the Lord speaking to us about or what is He, you know, dealing in our lives and how do we respond faithfully to that. So yung mga conversations na ganoon are so enriching and nourishing na kung wala tayo nun, let's not be surprised na nalalamig tayo sa ating spiritual life. And it's not just about, you know, Christian activity, going to the church building, you know, going through that motion of quote-unquote attending. Kasi kung wala kang connection with, you know, life-giving relationships with people, kung saan talagang you are able to talk about what really matters, you know, yung spiritual relationship mo with God and your walk with Him. Pag walang lugar for you to actually discuss those things, okay? Then there is no place for you to listen. There is no place for you to know what God is saying to you. So yan yung place na napakahalagang dapat natin maunawaan, no? Sorry for, you know, just taking some time to just review that because it's really very important na maintindihan natin. So we come now to this last place of grace na we are going to talk about for the next few days. And that is, of course, yung sharing the gospel. Now, this is a place na really, minsan hindi nare-realize ng mga tao how they miss out, no, a lot when it comes to really experiencing God's grace sa buhay nila. Being either, you know, as someone actively doing this or at least supporting this kind of work, which is yung, you know, pag-proclaim ng gospel sa mga tao, especially those who do not know it. Being in a place where you yourself, for example, can share your faith and can talk about Jesus with someone, or at least being a participant sa ganung klaseng endeavor, you know, in supporting that kind of activity. Being part, no, of reaching out to people who do not know the Lord and bringing them into the kingdom of God and helping them to know the Lord. That those kinds of places and activities really nourishes our spiritual life. Okay? So, in other words, you know, sharing the gospel with others nourishes our spiritual life. And please don't miss this. Napakahalaga. If you are not or have not, you know, maybe you cannot understand this very much at this point, but if you have not been actively sharing your faith or at least being part of the active sharing of faith, no, not just parang busy ka lang in the church, but really seeing yourself as participating, no, in reaching out to people with the gospel. If you cannot factor that in sa lifestyle mo, and you have no place or opportunity for you to either directly, you know, being ika nga actively sharing yung faith mo, maybe by God's grace meron kang ganong klaseng kapasidad, or maybe kung hindi ka ganon and you're not able to really speak kasi hindi naman lahat ng tao may kakayanan na ganon, but you are actively involved in making sure that it happens, you know. And there are many ways of getting involved in this, but I'm talking about being part of this work called, you know, sometimes it's called evangelism among church people, you know, evangelism. But basically, it's all about making sure that the gospel is reaching people who do not know the Lord. So being part of that and factoring that in your life so that you are involved in that, this is what nourishes your faith. This is what nourishes your spiritual life. And so therefore, pag wala kang ganong involvement, you know, you are basically, siguro nakikinig ka lang ng mga sermons, okay, paminsa-misa, nagbibigay ka siguro ng mga donations mo, but you don't really see it as being part of the gospel. You see, minsan nagbibigay tayo, but we don't really see it as participating in the work of the Lord. It's more like parang, oh, ito yung tulong ko sa inyo, ito yung abuloy ko, no? That's why before the pandemic, no, I always would say it sa stage, pag lalo na pag may giving part, no, please don't see yung giving as some kind of abuloy, kasi wala namang kabaong dun sa harapan, eh, wala namang patay, you know. We are participants, you know. We want to join together in whatever way possible according to the grace of God para may share natin ang gospel sa mga tao, okay? And that's what it's all about. Sometimes people, you know, are involved in ministry, pero they don't see yung ministry nila as being part of sharing the gospel. They see it as siguro, well, a ministry, you know? they just go there, siguro nasa tech sila or whatever, you know. But they don't really connect it with this work of bringing, you know, the gospel to people. And that's why itong storya na to in John chapter 4 is so insightful para sa atin, you know. The disciples came, they were busy looking for food. Dumating sila, and so sabi nila sa verse 31, Rabbi, eat something. Because they were busy sila sa mga concerns nila sa buhay. While Jesus was really concerned about, you know, reaching people like the Samaritan woman who do not know yet the kingdom of God and who have no knowledge yet of what it means to be saved. So nandun yung priority ni Jesus. So verse 32, sabi, but he said to them, I have food to eat that you know nothing about. Now this is interesting, okay? That even as a follower of Christ, we can be oblivious or parang unaware of this very exciting part of our life in the Lord. Now this can actually be something that can nourish our faith. Alam nyo yung mga involved sa, you know, evangelism, yung taking part in the work of the Lord. Sila yung laging on fire because they really see the hand of God working in and through them. And it's very hard siguro for you to imagine yung joy of feeling, of seeing people or even some person to come, you know, to come to the Lord, to come to faith and be water baptized and be joined in the community and to see that person grow in the Lord. The joy that you experience of being part of that, you know, is sometimes so hard to explain to people na hindi pa nila napagdaraanan yun. If you have not been part of seeing somebody come to Christ and know the Lord and grow in his or her faith and become useful in the kingdom of God, if you're part of that journey, or if you have not been part of that journey, parang it's so hard for you to imagine what this is all about. Kaya nga sabi ni Jesus, I have food to eat that you know nothing about. There are Christians who have been Christians for a long time who have yet to experience the joy of seeing someone come to Christ. And this is an area of opportunity na maybe some of you need to consider. Diba? Maybe you've been a follower of the Lord for a long time, pero you have not really led anyone to the Lord. You have not really seen anyone come to Christ as a result of your efforts. Okay? Now, maybe hindi naman siguro lahat sa inyo. I'm not going to be judgmental. Maybe there are some of you naman who have experienced this. And I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about. Kasi pag ikaw yung parang ginamit ng Panginoon to lead someone to faith in Jesus, at for some, in some way, na ginamit ka ni Lord para yung tao na yon makakilala sa Panginoon, karoon siya ng faith, ma-born again, tapos ma-join sa community of faith, tapos ma-connect sa mga tao na, you know, na ma-experience niya yung life-giving relationships with other people in the Lord, and makita mo siya na mag-grow siya ganyan, and you are part of it. Just being part of that whole journey is so wonderful, and it gives so much joy, you know, and nourishment sa ating souls. Na to miss that, actually, yung experience na yun is sayang talaga, you know. Some people, they tumatanda na sila sa Panginoon without really experiencing this at all. So, so in disciples niya, sabi sa verse 33, disciples of Jesus said to each other, could someone have brought him food? And yung sagot ni Jesus is classic, sabi niya sa verse 34, my food, said Jesus, is to do the will of him and to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. See, so this is God's work. The redemption of people who are lost is God's work. And if you truly want to be blessed, align yourself with the work of God in what He's doing in the world. He's right now saving the world, okay? He brought Jesus, His only begotten Son, into the world to begin yung process na yun, you know? He died on the cross so that people may discover true forgiveness by trusting in Jesus. And then through Jesus, he raised him from the dead and seated him at the right hand of the Father. Kung saan everyone who believes in him will now be elevated and raised up with him in the heavenly realms so that they will have a new status as children of God. And then he pours out his Holy Spirit, you know, so that people will now begin to experience yung transformation ng buhay nila. Together, as they come together in community with each other, as they listen to the Word of God and they obey the Spirit, you know, they walk in the Spirit. So, unti-unti, they are transformed from glory to glory. So, God is saving people, bringing them together, you know, iba-ibang nationalities, joining them together. And God is concerned na ma-build yung church niya in every place, you know, where there is no testimony of the gospel yet. So he's doing this work, and one day Jesus will come back. He will return to establish a new heaven and a new earth. And this is God's work. Now, sometimes we're busy in our own work, and we're busy trying to do everything else sa buhay natin without really aligning ourselves with the work of God. Now, it doesn't mean, of course, na lahat tayo magpapastor, you know. But what it does mean is you see dapat yung ginagawa mo in light of what God is doing in the world. And perhaps, you know, see what you're doing as somehow being part of that, di ba? And you should ask God, Lord, how can my work or vocation or whatever or career be part of your redeeming work sa mundong ito? Okay? And, you know, just being part of it gives us a sense of purpose sa buhay, because that is really the most important work of all, okay? And in this particular story, you know, what we see is Jesus making sure na he prioritizes itong work na ito. In fact, if you read the chapter in John 4, you would see there a very simple statement in, I think, in verse 4, na nakalagay, now he had to go through Samaria. No, he had to go through Samaria. Now, yung had to go is interesting kasi people, mga Jews particularly, do not have to go to Samaria. In fact, most Jews would go around para lang maiwasan yung Samaria. Kasi it's a place kung saan yung mga tao are not Jews. You know, mga hybrid. Mga, so, kumbaga sa Pilipinas, mga siguro Americans, ganyan. Yung parang hindi puro, okay? So a lot of Jews being ethnic sa kanilang orientation don't want to go through Samaria at all. They would avoid that. Kasi yun yung mga tao na feeling nila they don't want to associate with. Okay? Now, sabi niyo sa Bible, Jesus had to go to Samaria. Because there was someone there, yung Samaritan woman, that God wanted Jesus to talk to, no? At hindi rin yung Samaritan woman na yun, because she also belongs to a Samaritan town. And people there who do not know the Lord need to hear about the Lord. And in fact, yung Samaritan woman would be the catalyst for that to happen. So what I'm saying is that, you know, let's talk about yung primary thing, which is actively, you know, sharing the gospel to people. And to do that, we have to reorient yung ating priorities and see people as, you know, loved by God, as those that God cares about. Kasi pag ang tingin lang natin sa mga tao, mga customer lang yan na pwedeng bumili sa ating networking business, pag ang tingin natin sa mga tao, parang basta tao lang yan, we don't really see them as people, you know, created to reflect God. Pag hindi natin nakikita yung mga tao as they truly are, we might actually even be disinterested, you know, sa kanilang salvation. So it has to do with really changing our whole mindset and our whole sense of priorities. Gaano ba kahalaga yung mga tao sa paligid natin o yung mga kakilala mo? No? Do they deserve to know the good news about Jesus Christ? Kasi kung wala kang ganung orientation, you know, this is really, you know, the work of the Lord is something na parang added burden pa yan. You don't want to, you know, involve in that kasi marami ka nang ginagawa, eh, di ba? Marami ka nang inaasikaso, marami ka nang gustong pasyalan. You know, really thinking about people who do not know the Lord is not something that would come naturally to a person. Pero really, as a result ng silence and solitude mo, as a result ng being together with God's people and then, you know, having spiritual conversations, ang resulta niyan is a different outlook sa buhay, and you begin to see people as valued by God. And you want to rearrange your life in such a way that you can actually meet such people and you can actually have conversations with such people. Now, of course, one thing that is very important, especially for those who want to be actively involved talaga in sharing the gospel, you have to know the gospel. You have to know it, no? To be able to explain it to someone. Unfortunately, isa sa mga talagang sad reality is that we can be so involved sa mga church activities and not really know the gospel at all. No, kung may tututok ng baril sa atin and ask us, so tell me, what is the gospel? Some of us may not even be able to explain it. Now, you know, I don't want to condemn anybody or make you feel guilty, but it's just a point na kailangan natin ma-realize. And we cannot share the gospel if we don't know it. Now, siguro meron lang tayong basic idea, like, you know, Jesus is Lord, which is good, of course. He's the Savior of all. He died on the cross for our sins. Yes, you know. But is that all, you know? So my point is that we should go deeper in our understanding about the gospel so that pag may kausap tayo at kahit saang angulo pa yung usap natin, we can actually talk about the gospel. Because the gospel is multifaceted, you know? Maraming, parang like a diamond na merong iba't ibang mga angulo yun. You know, walang fixed formula ang gospel. If you read the Bible, you'll never see Jesus talking about the good news in just one particular way each time, every time. There are different ways of actually talking about it, di ba? And we'll discuss this more in the coming days. Pero what we need to understand is that dapat, as a Christian, the very first thing na dapat natin gawin is to make sure na nauunawaan natin yung gospel for ourselves, okay? In ever-increasing and deepening measure. What I mean is, kung nag-umpisa ka sa Christian life mo, na all you know is that Jesus died for you and that you are forgiven of your sins through faith in Him, that's a good start. Pero if you do not move forward from there, you would not really know the truth that you need to understand. Okay? For sure, this is the work of the Holy Spirit sa buhay mo. Pero you need to cooperate. Some Christians, you know, they do not make an effort, you know, to really go deeper in their understanding of the gospel. Mababaw lang yung pagkaunawa nila. And so, pag nagkakaroon ng mga problema, natitinag agad sila, bumabaksak sila because yung kanilang faith is very shallow, very minimal, you know. It's like, imagine mo, pupunta ka sa hospital at papakonsulta ka sa doktor. Or let's say, kunyari, yung doktor mag-oopera sa iyo. And For you know, you find out na yung doktor na yun, the only thing na alam niya about medicine is medyo may binasa lang siyang booklet here and there, nanood lang siya ng YouTube video once. I don't think you want to you know, put your life in the hands of that doctor. Parang hindi niya siguro alam yung ginagawa niya o sinasabi niya. You know, in the same way, we cannot be useful in the kingdom of God and we cannot help people kung yung pagkaunawa natin about the gospel is so shallow, no? That we really don't understand, you know, the full breadth, you know, and depth of God's grace. Now, I'm not saying na magagawa agad natin at one time. You know, even now, as a follower of the Lord, I continue to grow in my understanding. But my point is this. Kung tamad ka and basically contento ka na sa konting nalalaman mo about the good news, tapos hindi ka pa nag-share ng konting nalalaman mo, no? Ikaw mismo yung dahilan kaya ka matamlay sa spiritual life mo, okay? The reason why your spiritual life is not bearing fruit kasi ikaw mismo, you are not exerting any effort. Now, grace is not against effort, as I always say. Hindi porket we live by grace, it doesn't mean na wala ng effort, no? And the Christian life is a race, it's a discipline, it's a, you know, there are things that I have to do in my power, okay? While trusting in God's greater power, of course, no? Pero hindi si Lord ang magpe-pray for me, hindi si Lord ang, you know, mag-quiet time for me, hindi si Lord ang aaten ng, you know, a sacred gathering on my behalf, hindi si Lord yung magkipag-usap sa isang spiritual friend. These are the things that we do on our own, di ba? Sa sarili natin. We choose these things. And these things do not actually transform us, but rather they are means of grace in order that we can experience the grace of God sa buhay natin. So, hindi si Lord ang mag-share ng gospel sa friend mo. Ikaw yun. But sometimes we are so busy, we don't actually factor that in. May mga tao who come and go in our lives and they never really have a chance whatsoever to know the Lord and to actually walk with God. Nakakalungkot when we are a Christian and then others who we may have access to, hindi sila nagkakaroon ng opportunity to know what this life is all about. I'm not talking about just simply having a transaction, receiving Christ, ganyan. I'm talking about yung ano, really helping that person to start the journey and to continue on with the journey. Kasi the Christian life is not a transaction. The Christian life is a journey of faith with the living Christ, the resurrected Christ, together with others. It's a journey. So, ang goal natin ay hindi lang yung ma-receive ang isang tao, no? O, receive mo si Jesus and then tama na, success na tayo. Hindi. We want to accompany them in the journey. And we want to see them grow in their faith. And so, from beginning to end, if God will give us the opportunity, gusto natin na maging bahagi tayo ng journey na yan. And that's what I'm trying to say right now sa bawat isa sa atin. We'll talk some more about this in the coming days, pero I hope that you understand. One of the reasons bakit tayo nanlalamig sa faith natin and why is it na parang hirap na hirap tayo to really sustain yung ating relationship with the Lord is because hindi tayo katuwang niya sa ginagawa niya sa mundong ito. We're not part of the work that He's doing in the world. We are so busy with our work that we do not actually see the work that He's doing all around us. In fact, sometimes God is doing His work around us, pero we are oblivious to it. Hindi natin alam, hindi natin napapansin. That's why being part of a community of faith is so vital na yung community of faith na yun should really be a place where together with others na, you know, bilang kumaga parang team, we join together in doing the work of the Lord. For example, itong devotions natin is not parang ginagawa lang ni Pastor Bong. This should be our work. We should participate in it and we should actually help now for this work to reach more people and bring them to the saving knowledge of Jesus. This is our work. Ako lang yung nagsasalita, sure. Pero, kumbaga, I cannot do this by myself. The work of the Lord requires everyone's participation, you know, in the body of Christ. So as we join hands together, we can reach more people for the Lord, diba? But, you know, that's my point talaga na sometimes hindi tayo nakakaranas ng joy and excitement of being part of what God is doing in the world kasi hindi kasama yun sa orientation natin. We have to rearrange our lives so that we can be in such places, you know, where the gospel is being proclaimed and people are being led to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. Di maging bahagi ka nun is food, no, for your soul. It would nourish you. It would enrich your faith. You'll be excited about your walk with the Lord when you know that you are part of what God is doing in the world. And so my prayer sa lahat po sa atin, no, nawa that we would actually make sure na yung life natin is not so busy talaga that you cannot see any part ng life mo where you are actually involved in making sure that people is coming or are coming to the saving knowledge of Jesus. So it's time for us to repent. It's time for us to say to ourselves, how can I be involved? And we'll talk more about this because we can be involved in so many different ways, no? Pero being involved is the first thing na kailangan natin maintindihan. If you're just attending church, listening to sermons, okay, even attending a life group or a small group, pero you're not really participating in the work of the Lord, then, you know, maapektuhan yung spiritual life mo. Hindi ako magtataka kung parang magiging matamlay ka spiritually, wala kang gana, and so forth. Because everything else in this world will not really satisfy the longings of our soul. It's only the presence of God who can do that. Okay? That can actually accomplish that. Kahit anong lugar pa yung pasyalan mo, the only thing that you probably have is a temporary masaya ka, but at the end of the day, it will not fulfill the longings of your soul. Because we are created, no, to be in union with God and to be part of His work sa mundong ito. So tayong lahat po ay manalangin. Lord, maraming salamat, Panginoon, for bringing to our attention itong napakahalagang place of grace. Sharing the good news to people, being part of the evangelistic work of God's people, taking part and being right there in the middle of it all is such a nourishing experience for us, Panginoon. I pray for everyone na nakikinig, Lord, na ma-experience nila yung joy, yung fulfillment of seeing people come to Christ and journeying with them in their growth and in their faith. I pray na each and everyone, Lord, can really see that they are part of this work. And I know that when they rearrange their lives, our lives, in this way, that our soul gets nourished and we have food that other people may know nothing about. Pero it nourishes us and builds us up. And so this is my prayer, that we would just be able to see this truth and really rearrange our lives in such a way that we can be in such places, oh God, where the gospel is actually being shared and taught and spread out, Panginoon. So, salamat po, dear Lord, for the opportunity to be part of your work, dear Lord.